So what's going on this morning? And I quite have a special message you want to hand out this morning. But two of them want to address it at the pews. I want to put it off, they both got an audible paper. There's always a good practice to go in the church. And the root is a brother in the church in his house. So it's not an official way, but informal way, to have a special message to give them to an opportunity to bow with each other. So they can deal with it. And then once that's done, they'll be, not like we're not married, we're not given married, but 1 month now. And they also got married in Vietnam. So they got married here over the family there in Vietnam. And now they come here. I'm sure not to get married in
Vietnam. Thank you. I saw one.
So in the Christian sense, to get married to here. And the bride died. So this morning, today, we're planning to go to the celebration. So I want to talk about God and His relationship with the church. And for those who have been married and those who have not been married. From that, the Jews of Christ, first of all, is married to the church. Same with man and woman. But the world's view doesn't follow that way. The worldly view is a little different than our belief and how we recognize marriage and church. So this is what we do in God's house to have these traditions and recognize the Christian view of it. Right. And this scripture that tells us all about marriage, and we're working there. Just like how Jesus Christ is married to the church. And when I show you that, you'll understand how that relates to marriage. And explain to the wife law and the husband law in the marriage. Very simple, but not necessarily simple. But I will explain to God's view on it. Listen to the Father. Explain to Almighty God. Thank you for all the people here this morning to worship you, to celebrate the living and Lord's special day. Lord, just ask you to watch over them. And if we could learn more about the marriage years and support them. Thank you for the wisdom and the smartness. And that we can understand who you are, marriage is about. Thank you for everything you've done for us. So, first thing, we're going to look at the wise role. And in Ephesians chapter 5, 22 and 24, it talks about wise role. But in this case, we're going to take a look at Ephesians 5, 22 and 24. Husband and wife, and this one is on wife. So wife, submit to your husband as turn a little way.
Look at the black.
The world submit has many people can do something. For example, some people say submit in the wife is $1,000. She has cow to him and everything he gets. Like a sweat. That's not how you would submit. But submit to sacrifice all of myself or weekend to my husband. And so that would mean things in the house. Not that the husband is one up on the wife. Notice another country, in some Muslim countries, there's a tendency where the wives are extremely submissive. And there's something reaching for. That's why some husbands lose that vote. To abuse wives, but that's not really true, that's wrong. Absolutely not. It's not what that means. So you see right here, submit to your own husband. So I have a wife, a husband. Not any other man, no. She's never be involved with that man. She's committing to him and him only. Same idea as at home with a bench, you know, the white picket fence. You keep the gate shut. Anybody stays in the home, you leave the gate open. Anybody can come in and out. And so that's why, white picket fence. Everybody's community each other in the house. But that's why there's no temptation outside the white picket fence. Where you might be alone with another person. That's why we try to keep that separate. But the main thing is called the outside the fence. The temptation part of the
fence.
So 23 says, for the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, the wife. But Who has the most responsibility in the house? The husband. The husband's job to protect and lead. I ask for a little bit more later on. But if a wife to observe the husband, acknowledge the husband's role and responsibility. That's what we learn from the things that Adam and Eve. And we learn from Adam and Eve. Eve is a helpmate to Adam. All supporting Adam. That has given support at all times. Not cow-town, not intermixed, and has been not just like Jesus, he doesn't force us into his way. And we don't just sacrifice everything we have for him.
These are the roots.
But Jesus provides love, tenderness, and care. And so the fact that has been never noticed. Jesus doesn't
have
a window. So the husband is in the hair, just like Jesus is in the hair. And just like Jesus is the shepherd, and just like the pastors and the elders, so Jesus is the shepherd, elders, and pastors that are under. So we follow Jesus and obey him. So this means Jesus has sacrificed himself for the truth, to protect the truth, to provide for the truth, to help the truth, to give comfort to the truth. And that the husband is expected to do the same thing. Like Jesus did for all the husband is to do for the wife. Support, love, nurture, and not in a very unruly manner. And if you believe that, if you believe that the husband should do brilliant tactics and all that, that is not great. Not guiding. Because just like Jesus gave me a lot of grace, I need to give my wife the same amount of grace, if not. Just like wives and husbands, they can pick up one another and do the same with Christ. I'm sure there's a lot of. And then as the church submits to Christ, also wives should submit in everything to the husband. Follow, and provide, and sacrifice to the husband. And the husband is expected to do the same thing. The husband also is required to take care of the wife. It's still evil. The one that has the most responsibility of protecting the husband. It's not like the wife has no responsibility. The husband's job to protect her. For I notice here in America, and perhaps around the world, know why it's so gossipy too. How do you find the jail? And then a husband looks at the wife, chatting with a different man, and maybe he picked up. And he might go over and say, hey, what are you doing? Oh, this is fun. This is fun. My husband said, it's a very awkward situation. But who's responsible for that situation? The husband. And who noticed that odd behavior? The husband's responsible. It's the husband's responsibility. Go to the man and say, hey, leave her alone. That's my wife. But you know, in America, and to see that often.
But it's too big for me.
There's an ambassador to protect the wife. Let people know that that's my wife. And even if she has an affair, it's still to protect the wife. Continuous, yeah, that was talking to you through divorce. But divorce is not scriptural as well. That's totally different. The American, if you have a failure, that's it, we're done. Divorce. Not so bad. And there's always an opportunity for retention. In no situation when you're together, it's both probably fault. It's not one or the other. Just like in that previous example, I told you the husband saw this happening. You didn't do nothing. You too much of a responsibility. Just like with a husband, if a husband starts to feel jealous, and another guy is talking to my wife, and the husband tells his wife that, well, why should you respect that? Even if it's funny or whatever, you may or not. Shows that wives can be their own husbands. So when a man and a woman come together, they become one. Two in one. The share of men. Not this is mine, that's yours. No, I'm not sure. found in all of the Bible. Luke 95% of the I do the same. Not good. Both parts of the 100%. Now, husband's role. You just turn away. Now, this goes to the same moral as Adam and Eve start off with helping. So, a husband's role is what? To love your wife. That's it. That doesn't mean, there's another woman to his wife. Oh yeah, men can be tempted. We all know that. But we ignore that. It's important we love them at all times. Not be left them after anywhere else other than the wall. Right. You consistently love them all. He gives himself up for her church. I have to need to do the same thing. Be prepared to give yourself up to your wife. Kind of like being willing to die to your wife. So from there, the pain is coming in. And the wife falls in on the track. Husband should be controller of the wife to be loved. Just like sharing responsibility. For example, not feeling pulling around or sitting down and watching TV and drinking and eating by eating your work. Have to be kind of have an attitude and thinking to take care do love you. I go to work. I earn money. I provide the bacon for the house. Hi. Come on, Dad. I don't care what the reason or why, all the money in the world or whatever, how, yeah, those are necessary things. That's not what this is talking about. This is talking about providing two of our own, providing true love to your wife. You don't care, you can service me. Just like on Sunday, you know, baby, you have to watch Sunday football. But we watch it. We come to a watching football on the trip. Then you're the kids not your favorite team. But focus should be on how do the name exposed, why the name exposed, football comes aside. We all come together. Why go to church? You go to church. Just like that, I'm crazy about football. But now, there's something there. And I can copy and watch it every now. I can beat the officer. So I can walk you in the line. But, you know, 20 billion years ago, we couldn't do that. Now, maybe technology is quite good here. I can watch it again later on. If I my life. I was saying, don't tell me who won or not. You have to watch the game. But it can be that I need to get a common ground on the score, things like that. I can give him a hard time. But anyway, to the point here, my husband, he's a young. He's not fun.
Too big for me.
I'm walking with the fire.
Is it right?
If someone's got to marry you, that's what you have to communicate. That he might sanctify her, having come to her by the washing of the water of the word. So what that means is encouraging the wife, encouraging her with the devotion of time. To talk about the Bible, to talk about the scripture. Turn up to God's word together. Help her to know the world of God, to put any children
in there.
But sometimes you might have a revelation with God.
But it is a part of
the Bible. The Bible is spiritual. 27. Show that he might present the truth to himself in splendor. So this is talking about being a godly man. And not just being a Sunday godly person. And a simple Monday through Saturday. No. But a godly man is everywhere. At all without spot over and all, and instruction. might be holding in the tower. Anyway, they're not Christians. Not holy. But one where the husband and wife are unified. At the end of the day, the husband's responsibility is to take care of the wife and God in the house. Now that we talk about the husband and the wife role, we've got to know the husband now. No. I don't know how many groups are talking about husband and wife role. Husband able to find a way to endure and share such an important part of the people to report, and not just for the man, but that family, not her, not the woman, not the husband, any of that factor. That's why the two of you have got to communicate and learn from one another. And I'll talk in quiet. And I've been there. I'm not going to do a study on the weekend. At all times. Just like Jesus, love the poor, the husband should love the wife. And the wife and the husband should love the wife. So it's not very easy to try to satisfy you, but you have to look at it. But no one has ever been in his own bed. So you must have been. Tendency of men to always be receiving support got a good time in the market. Not doing something like, we're down the stretch, and he's got five. You're not too bad, you know how to do it. You gotta take care of yourself. I learned about it a couple of years ago. You must have a good connection. Then you get a computer or a projector on the screen. Everything's all connected properly. You'll be able to see it. If you're breaking the lines, you won't be able to see anything on the computer. Or if you're just broken the lines, something wrong with the lines. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and the two shall become one. Two and one. You got to get that two and one and then movement? Great. This mixture is profound, and I am saying that it is probably the right and the truth to one. However, that each one of you, loved his wife as himself, and let the wife see that she respects her husband. For all meekness shall his name. And if the wise respect the husband. But that's why the wise, suppose the wise didn't show any respect for a husband. Husband and wife have roles and duties. You are to share the countenance. You must share and commit 100%. Not 95%, 98%, but 100%. There is one trick where a man just cast the one out and got married on top of this man, got married and everything. And then the man says she wants to get a divorce. And the pastor said, well, why? And the man said, I'm so busy with work, and my wife wants to last him. It's a constant struggle. And the pastor said, you can't get a divorce for that. No. We love God our Father. We must learn to love your wife. That's all.
I almost crushed it.
But have you just not been in the war? You live in the war time.
What are you doing?
Love your wife. Show your love to me. And the Sultan was yelling bad, and the husband was a great patriot and a woman. And the Sultan had an affair.
I did.
And then, maybe now the time to get a divorce. And the husband said, well, I don't know, I need to go to scripture. And the husband said, all right, that's good. Come back to you. So the husband continued supporting her, and the wife matter? Why do we love you? Why do we share you? How do we maximize who you are for the world? Until all of you become stubborn, we need to have joy from God. Not joy of God, we will continue. Your cup is the Lord of God. So now, question I'm going to ask you. You can say, I do or I don't. Those are two responses. So I'm going to ask you. You two have a gentleman accept her as your wife. Continue as one. And no other woman, no other woman, no other woman. And sickness or in health. Whether it's a little skinny or a little fat. But smart. Yes, I do. Okay, that's my question. I repeat it again. So the line of God that I have to go to work with. No question, no doubt. And look, how it is. It doesn't matter. So then we'll get the ring. So one, so both have the what both you eat, never eat.
I can't do what I feel.
Most about three. What? You can move on and on and on. If I can stand a rock with the face, it's smaller and smaller. I can use any of the body in the face. The winning is a promise to continue on until one of you or both of you die. And send to the congregation. Do you promise? Do you promise to continue to God and enjoy your husbands and wives? And they are mutual wishes. Thank you.